Hello, BookTube. It's Terry from Terry Talks Books. I am here today to do a 2020 reading plans and channel goals video. I don't set very many goals for myself or big plans, really, because this is a hobby. I want it to remain enjoyable. And when I have too many things I must do, it's not enjoyable anymore. So I keep them to a fair minimum, but I also find it helpful to have some goals, and to some goals I need to quantify. Others I don't really need to quantify. Just having a loose goal will work for me. So the first thing that I want to achieve this year, as far as my reading plans go, is to continue to read off of Mount TBR. That is an old term. It was a challenge many years ago in my book blogging days. Somebody came up with the Mount TBR challenge, and I don't know if that's still going or not, but I have continued to use that for that terminology and consider my collection of unread books Mount TBR, because it truly is an astonishing mountain. So I want to continue to read off of that. I probably have around 1,000 unread books. This is many decades of collecting, acquiring books, and just not being able to read as fast as I was acquiring them. Like I said, this has been decades long. So these were many of the books I acquired while I was in school, doing grad work, and wrapped up in career activities, and sometimes the reading just took a side, had to take a side seat, and or a back seat. I guess it would be a back seat. And but I didn't necessarily curb my acquisition of books. So I ended up with a little much. So I wouldn't over worry having unread books, except I live in a tiny little place. It's a dollhouse. My husband is also a reader. And so between both of our collections and both of our, towers of unread books, it can get overwhelming. So we try to work on that. And this is my contribution. So I'm going to continue to read off of Mount TBR. And I don't have a certain percentage, a number every month. Probably what's been working for me is to just look at what I read every month. And if the majority of what I've read has come off of my TBR piles, then I will I consider it successful. And hopefully, since I've got I do keep a catalog of my books, and one of the categories is to be read. So as long as that number continues to go down, I'm happy. At some point I may say I want to get this down by a certain number, but right now I'm happy if most of my reading comes off of that. So my Mount TBR reading goal. And then I have what Britta Bowler called an author spotlight. And I like that term, so I'm going to go ahead and use it. But I will give her credit for that author spotlight reading. I have a couple of authors that I have had on my TBR, or just I want to read them. But all three of these authors, there's three of them, and they're all three women. And I have quite a few of their books, and I would like to either reread the ones that I've read so long ago I can't remember, or read the ones that I never did get around to reading. So those authors would be, first one is Louise Erdrich. And this one is, I'm just showing you a representative book from Louise Erdrich. This happens to be her first book. I'm pretty sure it was her first book. I don't know. I don't think she wrote anything before Love Medicine. And this was first published in 1984. And I read it in 1987. I think it was 87, 86 or 87. And it was much shorter. She reordered the sequencing in the book and expanded. So she actually added some things to it. So this edition that I have here is a 1993 edition. I'm not sure if I got this in 93, but that's when I believe that happened. And so I've had this laying around and wanted to go back and read with the expanded material and the resequencing. And at this point, you know, I read it in 1987. I do surprisingly remember a few things from this. I read the opening chapters and some of it was coming back to me. So the first chapter actually was very memorable to me. So that's pretty good for me to remember even that much. So I am rereading this, and I'm going to be also just going through Louise Erdrich's backlist. This is a co-reading project, a buddy reading project with Britta. We were talking about something else, and I mentioned that, you know, I want to read this, and she also wanted to read Erdrich's backlist. So this is a co-buddy read throughout the 2020. And so we're starting with this one in January, and I'm already behind. Hi, Britta. I'll be working on this book after the video. Anyway, so Louise Erdrich, and I should have written down how many titles for each of these authors. I didn't do that. Boy, I came prepared, didn't I? Okay, next author. So that was Louise Erdrich, and that's a co-project with Britta. The next author I want to read is Barbara Kingsolver. Again, I have read some of her works, not all of her works. Many of the ones I have read, I read again so long ago that it's just, I don't remember a lot. So what the next one is Bean Trees. I'm going to show you the Bean Trees. I believe this is Barbara Kingsolver's first book. I think so. And this was published in 1988, and I probably read it within a few years of that. So again, really long time, and I've read a few others of her books, but I am going to be starting with the Bean Trees. And I also, I was talking to someone I know in real life, my sister-in-law, and she got kind of excited when she heard that I was going to do this. So I think I have, hi Monica. I'm mentioning you. I'll have to send her a link. I don't know if she always watches these. But she and I are going to read it. She's going to read at least one of these with me. She said she would. So now you all know she said she would. So I don't know which one we will read together. Maybe there'll be more than one. I don't know. We still need to work that out. But I did mention it when we were out the other day, and she was very interested in revisiting or visiting some she hasn't already read. So I will be doing that this year, Barbara Kingsolver, and I do have a number of her books on my TBR to read. And then the third author is Isabel Allende. And what I'm showing you here is the House of the Spirits. And this one was first published in, okay, I can't see, pardon me, first published in 1982? Either 1982 or 1985. This is teeny tiny print. So it's been around for quite a while as well. And I read some of this while I was in the middle of finishing up one of my degrees. And because my undergraduate degree was in comparative literatures, I had a lot. I don't know why I even picked this up at the time, because I had so much literature to read. So I set this aside. I set this aside and never did get back to it. I did enjoy what I read. So I've always wanted to come back and read this, and I have quite the handful of other books by her as well. I went ahead and acquired them over the years because I liked what I read here. I thought, you know, I'm pretty sure I will like her other books as well. So anyway, so Isabel Allende, and I will be starting with a partially read The House of the Spirits, and then moving on to some of her other books from there. Okay, so Those were the author spotlight. Yes, I really am excited about this because these, I've just wanted, it's one of those deals where I really want to do this and then I don't do it. And with reading, that happens to me a lot. And so I'm going to do this. And then another reading challenge I have is, reading project challenge. Reading, in this case, I guess it's a challenge. And this is the German, the read-along of books that were originally written in German. This is something that is hosted by Britta Bowler and Mel from Mel's Bookland Adventures. And I will link them both below with some information about that because I didn't grab the official hashtag for that. So I will include that information so you can look into it yourself. But I decided that I was woefully ignorant of German literature. I remember reading some Hermann Hesse in the 1980s. I'm not even sure I have read any other German literature, you know, that was originally written in German. I've read things from many other languages, many other countries, and many other languages, and many other time periods, but for some reason, this is just an area where I just haven't done much reading. So there might be a few others if I sat down and thought about it, but seriously, Hermann Hesse is the only one coming to mind. So anyway, I will be participating in that, and there are various levels at which you can participate. You can read, you know, 1 to 2 books or something like that for level one, or 1 to 5 books. That's it, 1 to 5 books, I think it was, for level one. And then they have clever names, the different levels. I don't know how far I'll go with it, but I know that I can at least do something from the first level and go, you know, read one book originally written in German. So the read-along for the first quarter, they are also including, it looks like 4 titles that will be read-alongs, one each quarter. And the first one is called River by Esther Kinski. I went ahead and picked that up, so I will at the very least be reading this. I may get other titles and read those as well, but I will be reading this sometime in the first 3 months of 2020, so I can participate in the group read and also the reading challenge. This just looked really, it sounded very interesting to me. It says a woman moves to a London suburb near the River Lea without knowing quite why or for how long. Over a series of long solitary walks, she reminisces about the rivers she has encountered during her life, from the Rhine, her childhood river, to the St. Lawrence and a stream in Tel Aviv. Filled with poignancy and poetic observation, River is an ode to nature, edgelands, and the transience of all things human. That just sounded so good to me. And you may have caught on that I like nature writing, and I like things that have a poetic feel to them. I don't necessarily care that much for poetry itself, but a lot of writers are just, the way they present their work is very poetic. And so I love stuff like that. And it just sounded like something I really would enjoy. So I went ahead and picked this up and we'll be reading this. So those are my reading challenges, and checking the time, because I have some channel goals. And my biggest goal is to just keep making videos, because in the past I've had a tendency to disappear. I have had my YouTube channel since, I think it was 2009. I'd have to go back and look. I didn't do that either. See, I should get better at these things. I used to be better at these things. I was a lot more prepared. My videos at one point were looking pretty professional. I had, you know, the thumbnail, the opening, the closing, you know, all sorts of stuff. And it was just becoming too much for me while I had my career going. And at some point I just dropped off the map, and then I'd come back after 2 or 3 years. So this has been going on for, you know, at least 10 years. And, you know, that I'm surprised I still had any viewers when I came back. I think I had 350 or something like that. I was impressed. Thank you all for whoever you are for sticking with me over my long periods, long absences. And since I've come back this time, I've picked up maybe another 100 or so. So I'm not exactly too worried about growing my channel, but you know, it would be nice. It would be nice. I've met an awful lot of great people out there, and here's, you know, I get lots of, you know, ideas and reading suggestions by watching BookTube videos and just interact. I like interacting with y'all. So anyway, keep making videos. So if nothing else, keep making videos. Don't disappear. So this is why you've seen, you know, in order to get myself to do this, some days I show up, you know, I didn't worry too much about how I was looking. I didn't over worry my background or my lighting. I'm not doing any editing. I'm not even doing any thumbnails at the beginning at this point. And, you know, I needed to do that. Just go, you know, make the video and just upload it. Not worry about editing or any of that in order to make it happen. So I feel pretty comfortable with that now. And I really do want to get back to working on my presentation just a little bit. I'm not going to over worry this. This is a hobby. And I can do all of this professionally. That was part of what I was doing in my career. So I, you know, I made all sorts of educational videos and, you know, I understand how to do it. I just didn't want this to feel too much like work. But anyway, I would like to work a little bit on my presentations. And as you can see me constantly checking my time, I would like to get back to being a little bit more concise and not quite so rambly. The rambles can be a little fun, but I tend to go on, and so maybe shorten them up a little bit, tighten them up a little bit. Usually if I have written an outline or some kind of notes, you know, just done some prep work, I can shorten it up quite a bit. That's why you've been seeing me with some notes. I'm trying to keep myself on track. So I am working on that. That hopefully by the end of the year you'll see me getting those tightened up a little bit. I've thought about actual vlogging to help me with some of this. So just chatting whenever and then throwing it all into my editing software and putting it together as a vlog. I've been thinking about that. I'm not committed to it, but you may see one or two of those show up and I'll see how I like that. I mentioned the getting back into making thumbnails. What was there? Seems like there was something else. This actually goes, it's tied to tightening up the videos, but this actually goes back to kind of reading, my reading plans, and that is to take better notes as I read, and to maybe leave myself a little bit of reflection time between books. I tend to, you know, push myself sometimes, oh, okay, I'm done with that, and I move on to the next one. But if I'm going to talk, share what I've been reading, or, you know, especially if I want to talk about a book in any detail at all, I really do need to sit and think about it, and I do sometimes do a little bit of background reading, you know, and take some notes. That takes away from the reading a little bit, which is why I haven't been doing it. But I think I would benefit from doing that. Plus, I have those notes to go back to, so I find out, you know, 5 years down the road, yeah, I remember reading that. What was that about? So, I think it's a good thing if I just get some notes, or at least quotes out of the book. It'll tell me what I found intriguing, page numbers and quotes. You know, just doing that alone will help. So those are my reading plans and my kind of challenges and goals for my channel for 2020. And I have to tell you all, I have been enjoying hearing about your reading plans and your goals, and you've got me thinking, and I've kind of picked up a little helpful hints about how I might structure my own. And you might recognize it a little bit. You know, I've loosely incorporated some of those, but Anyway, I thank you all for being here with me and for sticking with me as I flounder about the place and try to be a part of the community. So thank you again, and I will talk to you all later. Happy 2020.